Africa tax experts say regional leaders should push for an inclusive global tax governance system amid challenges of rising domestic revenues and mounting debt fears. Africa's average tax to GDP ratio stood at 15.6% in 2021, unchanged from the previous year and remaining below its pre-pandemic levels, according to the 2023 edition of Revenue Statistics in Africa. The global tax system, according to tax policy experts, has worsened the trade with Africa by advocating for trade policies which favors developed economies. These sentiments were raised during a virtual press conference themed Reforming the Global Financial and Economic Architecture, organized by Ciatini and Partners. According to the Executive Director of Ciatini Uganda, Jane Nalunga, developing countries advocating for the reform of the global financial architecture to ensure a collective voice for fair and just policies that work for them.
And what that means is that we need a reform of how the global issues around finance, around the economy, around trade are managed, are governed. And why are we talking about this issue today, now? This issue is very important given the way our economies are today, given the post-COVID challenges which weakened our economies. And today we see there are many challenges. We see challenges of indebtedness. Most countries, especially in Africa, are indebted. A number of countries are using almost 40% of the monies collected in taxes to just service the loan. And we have seen a pushback, for example, in Kenya, in West Africa, people coming on the street to protest.
A 2013 report by the African Development Bank and Global Financial Integrity found that Africa lost between $1.2 trillion and $1.4 trillion to illicit financial flows from 1980 to 2009. Currently, one of the sticky issues around the international tax negotiations revolve around how multinational corporations should be taxed.
There are challenges of climate change. It's also a global challenge. We see also increased poverty, especially in developing countries where there are no jobs. We see externalization of labor, young people going out there to look for jobs. We see challenges of inequality within and between countries. The developed countries are becoming more developed. The poor countries are becoming poorer. But we also see a lot of outflow of resources.
The entire continent, 55 African countries, out of that $650 billion, only received $33 billion. So again, just to show and illustrate why this system is not working for the continent, and why it is very important for us to come and take a step back and challenge the existing framework by developing our own alternative models, by establishing and creating our own African institutions that can help deliver the kind of transformative finance that we're looking for.
With the current tax systems, pit capital-rich countries in the global north, home to many of the world's largest companies such as Facebook, Google, Amazon, among other capital-poor countries, predominantly in Africa. The key hurdle in taxing the digital economy is the 1998 World Trade Organization moratorium on customs duties for electronic transmissions, renewed every 2 years.